Technical debt is an everyday concept in software development. But how your team addresses and manages each type of tech debt determines how it will affect your software product's outcome. While some technical debts are intentional, other types are entirely avoidable. Is your development team making the necessary steps to identify, monitor, and manage your technical debt? Let's try to find answer of all these questions in this video. Friends, before we start, please turn on captions for this video for better understanding. This video will focus on definition of technical debt, the different types, cause, consequences, technical debt in Agile, and technical debt example. Watch complete videos and have all the necessary knowledge on how to avoid technical obligations. Please turn on captions of this video for better understanding. Thanks. Technical debt, also known as tech debt or a code debt, describes the results after a development team takes action to expedite the delivery of a piece of functionality or a project which later needs to be refactored. In simple terms, it's the result of prioritizing speedy delivery over perfect code. Technical debt covers everything from bugs to legacy code to missing documentation. The technical debt concept is that the debt represents the extra development work that arises when mediocre code is implemented in the short run, despite it is not being the best quality overall solution. Agile relies on reducing the scope of a release to ensure quality work instead of promoting many functions in a release. There is a technical debt that is passively created when the Scrum team learns more about the problem it is trying to resolve. According to the Scrum guide, the product owner is responsible for maximizing the value and the work of the development team. The product backlog represents the only asset of the requirement. The development team will work on and shall comprise of everything the product requires to be available. During sprint planning, the product owner discusses the product backlog item suitable to achieve the sprint goal. Let's see how to prevent technical debt in Agile. The first point is spreading awareness. The more developers and the clients are aware of the effect of technical debt, the higher priority it can take. The second point is following acceptable architectural coding practices. The next point is maintaining a high percentage of code coverage. And the last point is using issue tracker to stay organized. Friends, let's pay some attention on types of technical debt. It is vital that you try to understand how the technical debt is slowing down your team, and then balance efforts on delivering features in the short term with increasing overall productivity in the mid-long term. The three main types of technical debts are deliberate technical debt. In engineers' case, they know where's the right way to do something and the quick way to do it. However, at times, a team intentionally does something the wrong way because they need to quickly deliver products to the market, hence the technical debt. The other one is accidental outdated design tech debt. When designing a software system, a team tries to balance thinking ahead and future-proofing their design with the simplicity and delivery. As the system evolves and requirement changes, they might realize that their strategy is flawed or that the new functionality has become difficult and slow to implement. The third one is bit rot technical debt. Now, bit rot tech debt happens over time. A component or system slowly devolves into an unnecessary complexity through many incremental changes, often when worked upon by several people who might not fully understand the original design. Let's see some of the causes of technical debt. Time pressure, overly complex technical design, poor alignment to standard, lack of skills, suboptimal code, delayed refactoring, insufficient testing over time. Now, these factors result in the accumulation of technical inefficiencies that need to be serviced in the future. Unchecked technical debt may make the software more expensive to change than to re-implement. A technical debt that is ignored by any team may incur problems to the team, such as reduced forward motion. When a technical debt gets out of control and the development, the team spend most of their time paying off the interest payment from the first project, instead of working on a new feature or a critical new updates. The technical debt must eventually be paid, which comes at the cost of adding new features or working on other updates that move the product forward. Progress becomes stagnant, poorly designed code. In taking the quick and dirty route to reach the deadline, developers could skip the traditional protocol of writing clean, organized code. Thus, the code structure would be messy with a potentially low readability, the technical debt. Associated with poor design can be backlog of items related to cleaning up the code. The next one is volatile performance. The technical debt related to a product displaying volatile performance is related to fixing bugs, system crashes, and engineering bandwidth. Bugs in the coding mode might surface after releasing a fast production, thus incurring technical debt to fix them. The next one is drain productivity. Technical debt drains a company's team's productivity, leading to slower output. Poorly designed code requires more of the team's time and effort to manage it. Technical debt leads to the team slowing their build time and a slowing of the overall production test release cycle. The next is testing strain. With an impending launch deadline, the QA code testing team is forced to speed up their processes. They may possibly miss tests or swear to take them later. A technical debt is incurred to go back and carry out the skip test eventually. Incurring technical debt may sometimes be optimal decision. Too much technical debt can reduce a team's agility, produce low quality code, strain your testing team, and eventually reduce a team's overall productivity. Think of technical debt as a tool with the power to make or break the product release cycle. Understand it, use it, and manage it with a long-term view. Now let's see how to manage technical debt. The very first is deliberate technical debt. A team can manage deliberate technical debt by tracking this type of debt in the backlog and deliberately deferring work that needs to be completed. If a team can't follow it precisely, it's unlikely to be repaid and will turn into accidental design debt over time. Now, this kind of debt is incurred from business decisions. Therefore, stakeholders and product owners should be held accountable for the accrual. The other one is accidental outdated design tech debt. Now, how to significantly refactor a system is a huge task. But naturally, this needs to be happened now and then, every other year or so when the system is in steady state. Otherwise, a company team might over-engineer the system in the first place and incur unnecessary slowdowns all along. Teams, tech leads, and product owners should be accountable for ensuring time is set aside to resolve this type of tech debt incurred by design decisions and frequently changing requirement. Next one is bit rot technical debt. Now the bit rot technical debt is perhaps the only tech debt that a company should try to avoid at all cost. Strong teams take time to understand the design of a system they are working on, even if they did not design it initially. Incrementally improve the design and clean up wrong code along the way. The development team should be accountable for avoiding bit rot tech debt as individual developer incur it. There are a wide range of technical debt depending on an organization. Below are the examples of technical debt categorized by where they appear. The first one is technical debt in the code itself. Sometimes a project developer may write a module code, code whose modules are not cohesive, code whose modules are named weirdly and not according to what they are supposed to do. The developer may write ugly code or with long methods and lot of temp variable. The other type is technical debt in documentation. One of the most significant sources of technical debt is insufficient or out-of-date documentation. Usually, technical debt in the documentation comes from coder merely moving too fast and taking shortcuts. Ideally, developer document why they made their choices and what they intended when they made them, or why they grouped their entities into modules and so on. It's also a best practice for developers to update the documentation as they refactor and add to their code. Changing system design without changing the organization structure. Now the engineering teams are constrained to designing systems that copy the communication structure of their organization. Hence, changing the design of the system without also changing the organization structure leads to a technical debt. The other example of technical debt is too few or too many automated tests. Not having enough test coverage is a classic problem. Complex code is hard to change or refactor, and issues are tougher to identify and fix without automated test coverage up from the integration level. The code becomes resistant to change, hence technical debt. However, having too many fragile tests that break on every change and require more maintenance than the application code itself is a form of technical debt. The other one is outgrowing database model. Growth means more information in the code base, which in turn implies more technical debt. It is disturbing as the rest of the system often relies on the model structure. Changing the foundation of the database model has a ripple effect across the entire system, and tackling this is really just about refactor models. Friends, if you have learned something new today, please hit a like, and if you are watching it first time, please subscribe for more similar videos. Bye, have a nice day.